Commonwealth Games in Delhi, Scotland's shooters were the most successful of all our teams, bringing home 9 medals. John Hammond and Jen McIntosh became our most medalled male and female in a single games. John with 2 golds, silver and bronze. Jen with 2 golds and a bronze. But the detail of the sport is a mystery to most. Gold medalists McIntosh and Neil Stirton were happy to show me the ropes.
These are specialised glasses that can be easily changed in position. So you can turn these dials and slide them along the threaded part here. You can angle the lens, etc. So with these special frames, you've tilted the lens away so that when you've got your head down, you're still looking through the centre of the lens.
So do you wear glasses normally?
No, not normally. These are just to help correct very minute, it's about minus 0.25, and I don't normally bother with glasses.
Could somebody be a good shooter if they had bad eyesight?
Well, my pairs partner in Delhi and Jen, both are quite strong prescriptions.
Wear contact lenses.
So, you can have quite a correction needed and still shoot well.
If you're looking down, you can sometimes see the barrel and it just interferes with your sight picture. So this helps sort of block it out. Obviously, you still want to be able to look out and see the wind flags. So you need it to just cover and no more.
I've been shooting now for 17 years, and I think it's every year you're learning something new. So definitely, it's one of those sports that's extremely precise.
Jen, this is quite a fashion statement that you've got here as well. Do you want to explain what the jacket's all about?
It's basically to help you support you in position. The rifles are pretty heavy. This helps you sort of stabilise a bit and prevent injury.
And neither of you have mentioned this very confusing-looking big strap here. So what's this?
It's a sling. Basically, when you're in position, this wraps round and clips into the rifle here so that the rifle's kind of held up.
Now, if you were to try and hold a rifle that weighs nearly 6 kilos for an hour and a quarter, you'd never do it. The muscles would be tremoring and shaking. So this triangular platform, and actually when this is hooked into the rifle, is to give you that stable platform.
6 kilos, I think, is about a stone.
Yes, not far off, yeah.
Which is unbelievable. And you're standing like that for over an hour. Just down here, I have the targets. So this is the target that you would use for the 50 metres, the 10 in here, and that is just over a centimetre across. And you're not interested, really, are you,
in anything
other than that? And looking down there at the targets 50 metres away, and that, to me, is just unbelievable. And you have no magnification from the gun sights?
None whatsoever.
Jen has followed in her parents' footsteps. Her mother, Shirley, won gold in the 94 Commonwealth Games in Victoria. Her father, Donald, also an international shooter, was her coach in Delhi.
Do you think that shooting gets a bad rap, especially in this country? I mean, I would imagine it's quite a difficult sport to get other people enthusiastic about.
Yeah, I mean, it is difficult, but at the same time, I think once people have actually seen the sport, they understand how different it is and how it's, it's not related. There's no relation to any sort of, violence. I have had experiences of people that sort of are a bit standoffish about it. Particularly having lived in the Central Belt, it can be a bit difficult to get the sort of funding and stuff you want. But for the most part, people have actually been really supportive.
Was it in the prone in Delhi that you scored, 597 out of 600?
Yep, in the prone, individual prone. It was a new PB for me by 2 points, which is, at that sort of end of the scale, is quite a lot. I was very happy with that. It was scary in hell, but...
And what about the statistic of you being the most successful female medalist?
It's just brilliant. A little bit daunting when you're kind of like, oh, I'm 19 years old and I've done this with my life. Ooh! But it's great and really exciting.
It was time for me to have a go. And let me tell you, it's much tougher than it looks.
Loop it under and then try and get your hand. Is it not good?
Are you laughing, Neil?
It's quite amusing, actually,
yeah. Take the weight of this. Okay, so stretch your elbow out in front of you like that.
Right.
Okay, you need to shuffle yourself back a bit.
Okay, and there's just nothing natural feeling about this.
No, not really. And then
okay. in there.
Comes up into there.
Right.
And then just drop hand on the pistol grip up here. And then just drop the elbow down.
Okay.
Okay. Over there.
We're there, and I don't think I can move a muscle. But actually, from the shooting point of view, it's very stable.
Think you manage one?
I think so.
Are you pointing? Which one are you at? Can you see the letter A above the target?
I think it's the A one, yeah.
Yeah, that's okay. The one you want to be at, the right hand one.
Have I got to do that?
Okay, I'll do it for you.
Sorry, I just couldn't have moved. I was all set to fire there.
Okay.
Oh, right, okay.
Are you ready? Well, you hit the target.
Unfortunately, it was the white. You hit the target.
So there's your shot there.
Oh.
You want to do another one?
Yeah. I was hooked and determined to do better.
You're not selling the sport.
But it's tough. I mean, it is really, really tough. And then just tension all up there. And then in here.
In the lower back.
As well.
For a beginner, for the first time shooting, it's not bad at all.
I think I've got potential.
Put a bit of coaching, yeah.
Good, thank you very much. Oh, right, can you help me? Oh, put these down.